We want to solve the quadratic inequality 3x squared plus 7x minus 20 less than or equal to 0. Step 1, we want to make sure the quadratic inequality is in standard form, which we can see it is. Step 2, we determine the critical points, which are the zeros or solutions to the related quadratic equation, which means the first step is to solve 3x squared plus 7x minus 20 equals 0. Let's see if we can factor the left side. Because the leading coefficient is 3, and 3 is not a common factor, this will be a little more challenging to factor. We'll go ahead and use the method of trial and error. Because the first term is 3x squared, we'll place a 3x and x in the first positions. And now we place the factors of negative 20 in the second positions so that the sum of the inner and outer products is positive 7x. This is where it can be a little more challenging. For example, if we use a negative 4 here and a positive 5 here, notice the inner product is negative 4x, the outer product is 15x, or positive 15x, and the sum is 11x, which is not 7x. These are not the correct factors for the given trinomial. Let's try switching the negative 4 and positive 5. The inner product is 5x, the outer product is negative 12x, and the sum is negative 7x. Notice how we want positive 7x and we have negative 7x, so we have the wrong sign, but that's an easy fix. We simply change the sign of the 5 and the negative 4. Change this to minus 5, change this to plus 4, and now the inner product is negative 5x, the outer product is positive 12x, and now the sum is positive 7x. We now have the correct factors. And now to solve, the left side must equal 0, which occurs when 3x minus 5 equals 0, or when x plus 4 equals 0. Solving for x, we have 3x equals 5 by adding 5 to both sides, then dividing both sides by 3. We have x equals 5/3. For the second equation, we subtract 4 on both sides, giving us x equals negative 4. So we have two critical points, which we see from step 3. We now plot on the number line. The points are either open or closed based upon the original inequality. Because we have less than or equal to, because of the equal part, we plot these two values as closed points. If the inequality symbol was less than or greater than, we would use open points. So we have a closed point at x equals negative 4, and a closed point at x equals 5/3. The reason these points are closed is if we sub these values back into the original inequality, the left side is equal to 0, and 0 less than or equal to 0 is true. The closed points indicate these two x values are part of the solution. If they were open, the two values would not be part of the solution. Step 4, we now select test values in each of the intervals we created. So for example, on the left, we'll use x equals negative 5. In the middle, we'll use x equals 0. On the right, we need a value more than 5/3 or more than 1 2/3. Let's use x equals 2. And now we sub these test values into the original inequality in the original form or factored form to see whether the test value produces a true or false inequality. If the inequality is true at the test value, the entire interval is true and part of the solution. If the test value is false, the entire interval is false and not part of the solution. Let's go ahead and use the factored form to perform our test, which gives us the quantity 3x minus 5 times the quantity x plus 4 less than or equal to 0. When using the test points or test values, we don't actually have to determine the exact value on the left. We simply have to determine the sign of the product because we're comparing the value to 0. So let's first test x equals negative 5. When x is negative 5, 3 times negative 5 minus 5 is negative, and negative 5 plus 4 is also negative. A negative times a negative is always positive. A positive value is never going to be less than or equal to 0, and therefore we mark the interval as false. Next, we test x equals 0. Next equals 0, 3 times 0 minus 5 is negative, and 0 plus 4 is positive. A positive times a negative is always negative. A negative value will always be less than or equal to 0, and therefore we mark the interval true. And now we test x equals 2. When x is 2, 3 times 2 minus 5 is positive, and 2 plus 4 is also positive. A positive times a positive, of course, is positive. A positive value is never going to be less than or equal to 0. We mark the interval false. Looking at the number line, we now know the solution is the closed interval from negative 4 to 5 thirds. Let's express this using interval notation. Because the endpoints are included, we use square brackets. We have the closed interval from negative 4 to 5 thirds. Before we go, let's verify our solution by graphing the related quadratic function f of x or y equals 3x squared plus 7x minus 20. I've already set this up on the next slide. Here's the graph of y equals 3x squared plus 7x minus 20. Notice the two x-intercepts are the critical points we found on the previous slide. Because we're trying to determine the x values for which 3x squared plus 7x minus 20 is less than or equal to 0, and we have the graph of y equals 3x squared plus 7x minus 20, we look for the part of the graph where y is less than 0 or equal to 0, which is when the graph is either on the x-axis or below the x-axis, which is this part of the graph here. And notice the x-interval for which the graph is either on the x-axis or below is the closed interval from x equals negative 4 to x equals 5 thirds. The graph verifies our solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.